for your first act tonight. I'm bringing up your first act. His name is Mark Sawatzky. All right.
So
I was shoplifting at Dollarama last week, and I noticed that Dollarama now sells home pregnancy tests. And when I saw that, I thought to myself, if you're the kind of woman that buys a home pregnancy test from Dollarama, you're fucking pregnant. This is time. I had court on Wednesday, and as I was walking out of the court, they have this big wall of victim services brochures that you can kind of get on your way out of watching a trial. And one of them caught my eye. It said, "Help for homicide survivors." And I was like, if you're such a badass that you can survive getting murdered, you don't need any fucking help. But I picked it up and I started reading it, and what it actually was help for the survivors. What they call survivors is family members of people who have gotten murdered. Like, they should not call those people survivors. Like, hey, your brother got murdered?
Yes.
And you lived? How? The secret is you drink lots of water, look both ways before you cross the street. I heard about this documentary they were making a while ago called Iranium. And it's a documentary about the evolution of Iran's nuclear program. And it's very controversial. And I think that this DVD is bullshit. Because everyone knows that God created Iran's nuclear program in 7 days. Didn't evolve from anything. And they said there was this journalist, when they were going to release the DVD, Iran actually came out with a public statement threatening Iranian-Canadian relations if they released this DVD. And some journalist was like, release it anyway! What are they going to do? It's like they completely forgot that the movie was about their ability to destroy the world with nuclear weapons. So you guys can probably tell I'm a methoder. Nope, it's true. A lot of people when they're here, methadone, get in their head this dirty outdoor lineup going up to this window where you get your drink because you're such a heroin addict. But nowadays it's more discreet. I go to Shoppers Drug Mart and I stand in the line like all these other normal people, and I love it. Like, they treat me like such a normal person. I'm a normal person. I walk into like Shoppers in this lineup. I'm talking to the other people waiting for their medication. I'm like, hey, no, I'm a normal person. I'm a stand-up comedian. Why don't you come watch my shows? And then we'll get on, and then I'll get to the front, and they go, name, please, and they keep all the normal medication here. And the methadone is way at the back. So I don't want these people to know that I'm a junkie. So I'm like, yep, name Mark Sawatzky. And the pharmacist will keep looking in the regular medication until I actually say, actually, it's the junkie pile at the back. In which I have to announce to everyone. And like, my pharmacist is a Nazi scientist. not like a Nazi scientist, she is a Nazi scientist. Actually from World War II. And I'm certain that she maintains her youthful 85-year-old looks using gypsy blood that she's got stored away somehow. Like, they just passed this new law that I have to drink, because some kids died or something, I have to drink a bottle witnessed in front of them, and I swear she gets sexually turned on at this. Every time I come to the counter, she goes, "Hey, Mark, are you ready?" Yeah. And we go into this private room, and then she just stares at me while I drink this bottle of just disgusting medication. I'm like, "Oh." She said, "No, take the whole thing down. Take it down. Oh, no, the whole thing, please, just take it all. Yeah, medicate." Oh, and I'll finish this with it. Oh, that was great, Mark. Do you need a napkin? Fuck yeah, I do. One of the things I do in my spare time is I look at really expensive bombs on this website called useyourlungs.com. And I was reading their disclaimer the other day, and it said useyourlungs.com will not be held responsible for any damages resulting from use of this site or reliance upon this site. And basically what that means is, if you get addicted to this website, you fucking junkie, we're not going to be held responsible. And I was like, that is so ridiculous. Is anyone in this world actually addicted to using the stuff on your site? Like, "Here, man, do you need another hit?" "Oh, yeah, but I can only use a $900 glass bomb." "Well, you must be addicted to that damn website again." Oh, fuck that joke, I don't care. I live on Windmill Road, right by the harbor, and I walk down to the harbor, and there's all these great sea creatures, like starfish and crabs. And then there was this big, giant, majestic starfish, and I was like, "Wow, I'm gonna dry that out and make a bathroom decoration." So I grabbed him, and I dragged him to my bathroom. Just a quick day, and he'll dry out, no problem. My girlfriend was like, "Something stinks in the bathroom." "Oh, that's okay, I'll just take him out one day at the window where I smoke. One day at the window will combat that stink." And then I came and I kept smoking at that window, looking at his corpse rot. And I thought about how majestic he once was, and how he will never be a bathroom decoration, and how this was insane. And it is so sad when I look at his body every time I take a cigarette at that window. I look at his body, and it's just so disturbing. But I've learned a very valuable lesson through this whole thing, and that is that you're supposed to drown them in isopropyl alcohol before you dry them out. Anyways, that's my time. My name is Mark Sawatzky.